Hey, what's up and welcome everyone to another Warzone. Actually, this isn't even a Warzone video. This is a Cold War video. We are taking our very first look at the weapons of Cold War. We kind of got a sneak peek during the beta and the alpha to see what weapons were coming, but now we actually have the full list of weapons. So what I'm going to do for you is I'm going to giving you my live reaction. We're also going to be taking each one of these weapons as fast as we possibly can, taking them into the Warzone, into the Cold War, into a private match, shooting the weapons, reloading them, inspecting them, and firing them, and also be taking out one opponent so we can roughly see what the time to kill will look like as well. So hope you guys enjoyed today's video. This is all that it comes to when it comes to today's intro. If you want to catch all this live, I'm doing all my discovery stuff live over on Twitch. So if you want to see all things Cold War as they're unraveling, make sure to follow me over on Twitch. But this is your first look at all of the base weapons for Call of Duty Cold War. Enjoy. We're taking a look at all these for the sake of YouTube and just for the sake that we got a lot of new weapons. But this one we all saw before in the beta. It's the XM4, the M4A1. The weapon models look insane. I haven't even downloaded the Ultra, and they look really, really good. And I'm getting steady 230 frames. As you'd expect for an M4, even without attachments, it's an absolute laser. That's a reload for you. John, target, we can see ID. His health bar. Looks like probably a 5-shot to the chest to kill. We'll let him regen health and see how quick it can kill.
Pulling ahead.
Yeah, and with that's headshot multipliers on top of it, this is going to be one of the staple guns. I imagine this is probably going to be one of the CDL guns we see. Pretty impressed with it off rip. We were talking about it earlier with chat. There is no alt fire, which is kind of crazy. That's just lack of knowledge on my part, but some of chat is saying that no alt fire unless you actually have the attachment for it. So you'd attach a burst attachment, etc. All right, guys. Next one we have up, AK-47. It's pretty much been in every COD ever. There's the inspect. Nice thing about the inspect is you actually see the weapon inside the chamber. The AK's a laser, John. What? I think the M4 was like 5 shots to the chest. Yeah, that looks like, yeah, that would be 4 shots to the chest. But then stand far away. I want to see how well I can beam you, even on a head glitch. Oh my goodness. Dude, the AK is going to be nasty. Throw a side on it. This gun's going to be insane. Okay. What do we got next? All right. Next up, we have the Krieg. Kind of like the old school Galil. The reload animation. This one also a laser. Now keep in mind here, I'm trying to control the recoil as best I can. Without controlling the recoil, it'll climb. But it's just all these are very, very straightforward. Go ahead and jump down. All right, so a little bit more damage per bullet than it looks like the XM4. We'll obviously have to draw all these together. We'll have something like true game data. Take a look at it.
Close.
All right, so this one's got the QBZ. It's actually got a pretty sick weapon inspect. Very fast fire rate, pretty fast reload too. I wasn't expecting that from such kind of a chunky looking gun. Shots to the Tally chest. One. Pretty similar to the Galil.
We're in the lead.
Sounds dropped fierce. Him. And it's a little bit, it's surprisingly, it's bouncier than the AK. I'm kind of surprised on that. All right, and the FFAR, from my understanding, this is like the fully automatic FAMAS. Is your inspect, come on, pull the bolt back. No? All right. No pulling the bolt back, unfortunately, on this one. Give it a little brush. Very strong recoil. Like, if I let that thing go, it climbs like crazy. There's your reload. I think I shot you 2 times there. I think it's going to take you 7 shots to kill. Six shots to the chest to kill you. Okay. But it fires pretty fast. Interesting. Honestly, out of all of them, if I were to level up any of them right now, I would probably be leveling up the AK. AK's got, it's got a lot of butt wobble. So like as you're shooting, you know what? With the bolt flying back and forth, it's a little jarring and you kind of get like that butt wobble that you get with the MP5 on Modern Warfare. But I feel like this gun's going to be the gun to go to. Maybe the XM4. I felt like the QB was way too bouncy. The FAMAS recoil, especially on controller, is going to be insanely difficult to control. The Galil's pretty nice, the Krieg. And so I could see that one being pretty viable as well. But if I were to pick any gun to level up instantly, I would probably be shooting for the AK. All right, let's check out the SMGs. First up with SMGs, we got the MP5. We all know what this looks like. Good looking gun. Reload mechanic. From range, that's tough. So the worst part about that, vertical recoil is very easy to control. When you have recoil, watch how much it bounces hard left to right. Shooting someone from far away, that's bouncing off frame side to side. If it climbs up, that's fine because you can just drag it down and it's dragging on their frame. But when it's bouncing off side to side, that's when you miss shots. Okay, up close, 4 shots. Seems like that's about the same on with some of the ARs.
Kilder.
That's crazy. So even with the larger caliber rounds coming out of an AR, obviously they have longer damage at range. But if you're still aiming downside with an AR, it's frying. Granted, fire rate plays a large, large role in this. The Milano. This one was nasty in the beta. This is probably my favorite gun to use in the beta. Caress. Pretty quick stock reload. Oh, I'm trying to control that. It is all over the place, left to right. It is left to right and up and to the right. Yikes. Ooh, did I get a headshot there? I may have. You died really quick. No, this gun just hits that hard. So whereas an MP5 takes 5 shots to kill, this only takes 4. AK-74U. Well familiar with this one. This was pretty much by far the best gun in the beta. I like the Uzi better. But whenever I was watching like little, you know, custom scrims going on, this was the gun to use. Not as fast as the Uzi with the reload. Still bounces all over the place. That's at range. Similar damage profile. I think the Uzi actually does more damage per shot. It's kind of nuts. What?
Enemy deleted.
Next up, KSP 45. Basically like your ump. Burst fire. Was not expecting that. Fairly quick reload. That's me pressing as fast as I possibly can. There is quite a big delay between each shot. And you can just see from a distance, they are not lining up. All of these have like a side to side. This is probably like the worst weapon in the game. Who knows? Maybe it probably one burst to the chest. Yeah. So it hits hard. It's a 45 round. You know, it shoots 45 caliber as opposed to a 9mm. Something you would see out of like the MP5. So it's a one burst to the chest. But if you don't hit all center mass to the chest, you're gonna have to get that second burst off, and that's probably when you're gonna lose the gunfight. So yeah, no shot. I'm probably gonna call that one the worst SMG off rip right now. And last up for the SMGs is the Bullfrog, or the Bison that we're pretty familiar with in Warzone. Pretty quick reload time for a 50 round mag. Really nice iron sights on this. Probably my favorite iron sights we've had so far. And recoil's all over the place, but then again, it's not an AR, so what do you expect? It's a little bouncy. But I feel like at close range, it's manageable. See where we're at. Another 5-shot. But man, that iron sight is clean. Iron sight is super clean. I would still have to say, I don't know, chat, what's your favorite? I'm thinking MP. Oh, AK-74U was awfully popular as well. MP5 is always the best gun. It wasn't Modern Warfare. Okay, that is pretty bouncy.
Appears KIA.
MP5, AK-47. I think there's gonna be a nice balance in the SMG category for sure. All right, first up of the tactical rifles, we got the Type 63. Classic semi-automatic. They had to have hired someone new because their weapon animations were terrible in the beta. I feel like they hired the guy from Modern Warfare because these all look exactly how they should. And look how much that butt kicks back into you. But honestly, I like it more than if the SKS. So in this one, like the butt comes back towards you, but in the SKS and Modern Warfare, like the iron sight is bouncing all over the place. I feel like I can actually shoot this one confidently. Tactical rifle. A 3-hit to the chest? I don't know about that. Yeah, 3-hit to the chest. And it's not even a one-shot headshot.
Threat clear.
No thanks. The classic M16. You love to see it. It's got a 20 round mag in real life. This is a 20 round mag, but sure, we'll say that it fits 30. That animation is clean though. First fire as expected. Pretty quick reload too. And very little recoil at range. Yeah, that's going to be a sight to see. And we can only imagine.
Smoke checked.
Okay. Dude, this reminds me so much of the Call of Duty 4. Like, the OG Modern Warfare.
Isaac, try from distance.
Try from distance? Okay, wait. Okay. Ooh. What's your health regen? Did all three hit there? I think only two hit.
I think all three.
Let me step up a little bit. Interesting. So I'm imagining you throw on a suppressor. You get some headshot multipliers. I'll try to hit no headshots here. Yeah. So at close range, it's a one shot. At medium range, imagine I throw one headshot in there. I think you throw a compensator on there. It'll in a red dot, it'll fit just right. Throw a longer barrel. Yeah. All right, next up we got the AUG. That's a good looking inspect, man. Comes with its own scope. Only thing I hate about a scope like this is it obscures a lot. Let's say you're aiming down. Look how much I'm aiming and I miss John and all of that. I'm sure there are some other sights that go with it. That is a chunky, chunky rim around that sight. Almost no recoil. Pretty quick reload. I imagine it's one to the chest. Yep, one to the chest.
Good effect.
Let's take you up there into that window again, see if it does any better than the M16 did. A little bit more damage, I think. I'm gonna try to get a headshot in there.
Bushwhack.
Okay. I like it. Like I said, I think it needs a better sight on it to be really reliable. But I was saying you also needed a sight on the M16 anyways. The DMR-14. I honestly should know what this gun is in real life, but it almost looks like a modernized M1 Grand. What? Oh. I should know what this gun is. Really clean iron sight. This is throwing me back to some like World at War. Oh, EBR. M14. Yeah. Nice. Let's go, chat. Pretty quick reload, too. A little bouncy. So, they do a nice job of making the iron sights stay on point if you look deep through the iron sight. But a lot of these guns, the butt of the gun is like bouncing like crazy. See how it looks at close. Yeah, it likes to bounce around. I'm not moving my mouse at all. See what it does. Is it two shot? It is not. M1 carbine. Okay, one of those. So just like the very first gun, it's going to take three, but at least this has a much faster fire rate than that SKS lookalike.
Just dropped.
I really don't know if DMRs are going to be valuable at all. The AUG looked pretty nice. The M16 looked pretty nice. But burst fire scares me because of how much time you lose. Yeah, I mean, that's just like... That's bouncy. That's all over the place. Yeah. I don't think I would run a single DMR. I'm a guy that loves precision, but I don't think I'd run a single DMR. All right, so the very first LMG you have is the Stoner 63. This one was in the beta. There's the inspect. Very long aim down sight time. Kind of like whips up from under. Very manageable recoil, though. In a pretty... okay, it was almost fast, but then all the extra stuff at the end kind of made it a little bit too much. Yeah. Four shots to the chest. So basically the equivalent of an AK. Probably a little bit faster fire rate than the AK. And obviously you can lay down some hate. Very little recoil. Seems like it could be a Warzone gun. That reload time is a little bit too fast long for me. So the final parts where you had to like close the lid and then pull back, that seemed a little bit too much. And frankly, you don't need to do that last part, I don't think, if you already have one in the chamber. So all right, next up, second LMG, the RPD. A lot of Soviet era weapons. Very fitting. That one's a lot bouncier than the Stoner. I'm trying my best to control it, but it's up and down. It's all over the place. Pretty fast recoil though. Four shot kill.
Target removed.
Just like the other LMG, the Stoner. It is definitely not. It is definitely not as easy to control as a Stoner, though. M60. Legendary. Nice weapon inspect there. Iron sight definitely to get used to. Oh my god, this is atrocious. Nope, this isn't it. This is not it. All right, so the longer you fire, it starts to refine, but by the time you put that many bullets down range, but watch how bouncy this is. Do you see that? Within like the third shot, it was shooting over here. Watch. The second shot, I'm shooting 5 feet to the right. Interesting. All right, let's see how much damage it does. Hopefully it's a tank. All right.
Appears KIA.
All right, so it kills faster than the other two. So it's not an absolute laser. The Stoner might be your laser of an LMG. This one's a bouncy boy. This might actually be one of those where you want to be posted up with a bipod or something. Even proned. Look at it proned. Unfortunately, you get on target. This is like your... John, come through that door. I want to see if I can even kill you coming through that door, knowing that you're coming. Proned out. No attachments. Even if I'm camping you, it's still... The first shot bounce off target is insane. Watch. I shoot once. That alone makes me not want to touch it. All right, the Pellington 703. Oh, he's fancy. He's fancy. Dude, imagine the trick shots you're going to see with that. Wait for it to pop. 360 YY. Phase up, brother. I'm not crazy about the aim down sight in this game. Because the way it does it, Modern Warfare lets the gun come straight to you and you see the scope get larger and larger and larger and there it is. This, you like bring it up from the bottom and you scoop it and it's just like, bam. So when you're like aiming far away, you can't tell if you're on target or not until you're right there. Modern Warfare, it kind of was more gradual. All right, so let's see if one shot to the chest. Okay.
Tagged him.
One shot to the chest does it. Let's see if one shot to the stomach. Nope. One shot to the stomach is not a kill. Let's check the shoulder.
Good effect.
Looks like shoulder is one shot. See if one shot to the arm is. The one shot to the arm. Okay. So it seems like upper chest and arm. But if you're hitting stomach, stomach isn't going to get you a kill. What about damage range? That's true too. So let's see from a range if I hit the arm. So even from the range.
Threat down.
So it's basically upper chest. The LW3 Tundra. Anything fancy on this one? No, you're just wiping some dirt off. Okay. Once again, a scooping and a snap. Pretty quick reload. That's as fast as it can fire. Let's see if you can do a stomach shot. No stomach shot. but it can do an upper chest. Frag. So I'm really trying to figure out what's the significant difference between those two guns. All right, so what's the big difference between these two? Aim down sight speed. The Pellington is much snappier. Fire rate. The Tundra is slightly slower. The Tundra is also magazine fed, whereas the Pellington is not. But I feel like the Pellington also has a little bit less sway, and I feel like I move around faster. Yeah, I'm definitely slower with the Tundra in my hands. So I feel like, just as we saw in the beta, the Pellington is going to be the Quickscoper's gun.
Target removed.
The legendary M82 50 caliber. Oh my god! Look at that chonky bullet in there, bro. Yep, we love that. And still a relatively fast aim down sight time. It doesn't feel that much slower than the than the Tundra. Huh. See, that could be like a really good if someone's rushing through a doorway. Oh my goodness. So John, I think you're dead. What? Okay, so you can survive getting gut shot by a 50 caliber. You die by that with a Pellington. With a Pellington, you die by that. What is this gun? No shot. That was in your upper chest. It's broken.
Bushwhacked.
All right, we gotta try this again. Stomach shot. Leg shot. Okay. Upper arm.
Sorry.
All good. I'm actually stunned, so that was very fitting. Upper chest. So there's like, there must be like a U or something right here. Balance for fire rate. What? Am I just gonna... did you see how little damage that did? Look at that. Look at that sliver of damage. This isn't attack rifle, chat. This is a Barrett 50 cal. That's upper chest. That's a nice DMR. You're right. So there's like an upper chest, upper chest that it'll kill. What? I'm disgusted. This was not meant to be. sensationalist at all. This was just supposed to be like looking at the new weapons. That's disgusting. They murdered that gun.